This is gonna be another Freiburger zero production quality video. I'm gonna tell you about my 2002 Jeep TJ, the generic Jeep. Whenever I post this thing in social media, a lot of people ask me about it, so I thought I would do a video just giving you a walk around about what this thing is all about. Basically, this is my drive on the highway, camp, light duty four-wheeling rig. This is something I want to be able to hop in with my kid and just never break anything whatsoever and just do a whole bunch of real mild trails. It's actually set up so it can do some amazing stuff, but we don't. I use my scrambler for that. So let me just start at the front and work my way to the back about all the stuff that we've got going on here. So up front, it's got a worn X8000i winch on it. This was actually on the thing when I bought it, so I didn't install that. I did install these little LED projector beams right here. These are for a tow bar, but I pull them out and actually use these for an anchor point for a rescue hook or loop or something like that. So those are pretty handy. A lot of people ask me about this thing right here. See how the winch hook is pulled back into this piece of polyurethane so it doesn't rattle around and so it's captured there? That's made by Daystar. I don't know why so many people ask me about that, but they do. So the drivetrain on the Jeep is pretty much bone stock. It is a 4-liter inline six. You can see there's really been nothing done to it. It doesn't even have a cold air kit on it. I don't like the cold air kit because I don't like the off-road function of that, just sucking up a bunch of dirt and water and everything. I prefer to just leave the stock air box on it. So really the only thing that's aftermarket under the hood is the Odyssey battery and some wiring and stuff like that. So there's nothing special here whatsoever. It does have the stock 5-speed manual transmission, which is an NV3550 in this particular year. And the transfer case is a Rubicon unit. It's an MP231OR off-road unit, which is the 4-to-1 gear set. And I've got it modified with a TerraFlex arm in it so that I can do four-wheel drive low and two-wheel drive low. Of course, two-wheel drive low is something that's not available on a production transfer case. Let's look up underneath the front of this thing, and you'll see what I've got going on for suspension. We'll start with steering. It's got a stock box on it, although at home I do have a Durango box ready to go on the thing. It has over knuckle steering set up on it, crossover steering. I believe this kit is from Iron Rock Off-Road, although it was on the Jeep when I got it, so I'm not 100% sure, but I believe that's what it is. One tip about this is every time I put gas in the Jeep, or nearly every time, maybe every third time, I carry a can, a liquid wrench lubricant with me, and I just squirt all of the heim joints on it because they do tend to squeak if I don't do that. The front axle, as you can see, is a Dynatrac ProRock 44. It also has a ProRock 60 in the back. That's obviously my biggest investment in this entire Jeep. That was all about me not wanting to be in the middle of nowhere with my kid and breaking an axle and being stranded. I wanted to have zero possibility of ever breaking an axle, and that's what I got with this stuff. It's got the RCV axles in it, as you can see, with their special ends on it and everything, and the way we use this Jeep, I will never have a problem. It's got 488 gears in it and air lockers front and rear. The suspension on it is, I don't know, they're mystery coil springs up front. I'm about to change them to some progressive Currie coil springs that I've got, and it does have Rubicon Express shocks on it. I'm about to swap those out for some Bilsteins that I got. It does have JKS sway bar disconnects up front. The lower arms are adjustable Curries, I believe, and the uppers are stock in the front. Okay, let's move around to the back side of this thing. Got the original white paint. Everything's in pretty good shape. When I bought it, it had a soft top on it. I did convert the thing to a hard top just because we use this thing so much on the highway. It was better as far as wind noise and cold and things like that. The tie rack on this thing is from Rock Hard Off-Road, and it is pretty beefy. I like it. It's got tow hooks on it. It has a trailer hitch, which I've never used and likely never will. And it's got the swing away tire carrier that does carry the 35-inch tire. And normally it carries my high lift jack also, but that's not on here at this time. I won't say that this is as rattle-free as they advertise it, but this bumper is torn on it, and they advise that you add another bumper right here that I don't have, so I cannot fully complain that it is not as advertised because I don't have it installed completely as advertised. You can see I've got my dog decal right there. You can get those at my site, shop.davidfreiburger.com. So in the back, this is really cool. You can see that I actually custom made this whole shelf here, and it has these rails on it that you can move the anchor points out and wherever you want to put them. And so when we really go on big trips, we will often put a cooler right there. Hold on, let me get that back in. And we can also strap things down, because one of my biggest fears is rolling over and having all the cargo hit me in the back of the head. So it's got tie downs up top, and in the bottom, you can see that I take with me everything that I need. I got a tool bucket. Here I've got rescue chain and strap. I've got my safety seal tire plug kit. I've got my high lift base. I've got spare air locker line in there. Here's that stuff I was telling you about that I carry to lubricate the heim joints up front. I also have a pretty nice Vi-Air portable air compressor there that we use for taking the air pressure up and down. And I do carry a battery-powered, impact wrench there for changing tires anywhere that we may be. So this setup has been really, really nice. I like it. It took me about a weekend to make this whole thing, and I found this carpet that is the same color as the carpet in the car that I was able to cover it up with and everything. It's cool. You'll notice I do carry a very complete first aid kit. I also have splints and everything like that. Okay, now that we've had a little look-see there, let's look up under the back of it. And you can see the, you have to go way down low up under here, and you can see that it's got that Dana 60 Dynatrac ProRock and disc brakes with parking brakes in them. And the Bilstein shocks are already installed here in the back. Took me a long time to science out the lengths on those. Turns out that the shelf units that were recommended for a 4-inch lift did not work on this Jeep at all. So I had to get custom lengths on that in order to have my compression rebound just right. And it does have Currie progressive springs in the back, and the arms on the back are 100% Currie as well. So I guess the last thing on the outside is going to be the wheel and tire combo. I just got regular old cheapy 15 by 10 black steel wheels that were on it when I got it. The tire is a Cooper ST Maxx, which is their sort of tweener tire. It is a 3-ply sidewall. It's an aggressive all-terrain. If you look earlier on my YouTube channel, there is a review on these tires when I first got them. I've now got maybe another 5 or 10,000 miles on them. I haven't kept track. And I will say I like them a lot. It's amazing how quiet they are and how well they have performed in the terrain that we go in, which is basically rock, sand, desert exploring. They've been really, really good, and pretty good in light mud as well. The thing I don't like about them is the sidewall design and the fact that when you air them down a lot, they actually fold right here on this pinch, which I don't really like. All right, let's have a look at the interior of the thing. It's all stock in beige. To me, it was very cool that I was able to get the TJ with a beige interior. Most of them are, you know, that dark gray or black. The only real mods that we got going on here is that it has this roll cage in it, which again was in the Jeep when I bought it, and I think it's an iron rock unit, but I'm not positive about that. But I do feel a little bit better about having that in there than just the factory sport bar in the thing. You can see that it doesn't go tubular all the way down to the floor of the frame. It just bolts in here where the dash bolts on, but nevertheless, I think it's pretty good. I also have a pretty good stereo in this thing, and here's a tip that a lot of people like when they see it. See how I've got this little focal speaker attached to my roll cage right here? Look how it is on one of those clamps that you can buy from like the chassis shop. It's just a two-piece clamp that goes around the roll bar, and it has a screw hole in it. And then, let's see if I can take the speaker out. You can see that just that screw holds onto that clamp, and then that tweeter holds in right there. And it actually works out really well. You can see that I've got zip tied on here. I've got my, whatever that is, Victorinox tool on there, safety emergency tool. I've got a Leatherman over here underneath the seat. I've got, you know, a good trenching knife. And over here, I carry my ARB quick air down stuff. So I've got this thing all set up so that we can leave at a moment's notice, which is what we did today to go explore here at the old Ridge Route here in California. Unfortunately, the reason I'm making this video is I needed a few minutes to let this thing cool off so I can get my arm up underneath the thing, because the transfer case shifter fell apart. So I'll be putting that back together just as soon as we end this video. So there's more detail on my generic Jeep. Look at how hashtag generic Jeep on Instagram. You can find a lot more pictures of this thing, but there's your basic rundown. Oh, I forgot one thing. See, these are stock fender flares, but they've actually been trimmed back about 3/4 of an inch for extra tire room. A lot of people ask about how we fit 35s with that. That's the way that happens. Okay, there you go. The end. The generic Jeep.